picture me rolling. Sixes, money falling, bitches, honey, that's rolling. The richest, knives get in ya. Most pretty grand claim, Pulitzer, prize winner. Best storyteller, thug narrator, my style's greater. Model data, big threat to a lot of you haters. Commentators, ringside, pop, watching my paper. Almost a decade, quite a hustler. Most of the best is in the essence. Rap shit that I stand for, expanding more to the big screen. Bill Gates dreams, but it seems you'd rather see me in jail with state dreams. Want me off the scene fast, good things last, like your favorite MC, still making some mean cast. First rapper to bring a platinum plaque.
Welcome, welcome to the show on the Saturday afternoon. You have been hosted by BLK Prototype. I'm here to give you entertainment on the highest quality of PUBG play right now. Today in this lobby we have a 6-man squad game in Sanok. It is normal mode, all things are go, TPP, and we're on an OC server. It's gonna be litty. Who's ready? I am. Let's go. Team 1 consists of Winston, Ambush, Dust, Hyper, Jefferson, it's me, Who Kid. Team 2 consists of XJB, Codfather, Thread, Young Dizzy, Ibell, number 6 just left. Nope, back in with Left Field Poppy. Left Field Poppy's back into this, guys. 61 in, we're getting there now, guys. I think we're going to have to look out for team 12 or team 11 here, guys. Viper 130, known all around the scene as a high kill player, very very talented, very very accurate. Get that car 9 and M4 package and he is unstoppable. Behind him we've got Booker's 15. Booker's 15 has been around the game from the game, actually was pre-released back in the day. Bravo GB, not really heard of this guy, but the guy below him, Diablo 130. These are part of the 130 squad here, guys. Diablo, Wizard, and Viper, all part of this 130 squad. Booker's 15 is just behind them. And then we have Crow the Ninja. I think that's a Spanish dude, I'm not too sure. So it looks like Left Field Poppy has moved to number 12 there and letting Wee 114 in. We 114. Let's see if there's any numbers behind the 130, guys, if they need into their squad. No, it seems to be there is only 3 of them in that squad. Looking about the map here. No. Here we have another big hard hitter. We have the Raven 216. The Raven 216. Let's see his stats. Let's see the Raven 216. He has got a 0.71 KD, guys. Out of 17 matches, he has 12 kills, 2 being his highest. The bushes were strong with this one. Let's go ahead and look through another couple of stats here, guys, while it fills up. Let's go to Daft Silas's. No, we're not going to kick him. He's got a 0.63 KD, guys. Very, very strong here. He has 5 kills over 8 matches, most being 2. And the longest kill of 34.6 meters. The bush is strong in this one. Italian Curry with a 1.05 KD. He has 274 kills. Most in the game was 8. 6 of them were AFKs. He has 1 win from 263 matches. The force is strong with this one also. Then we have Big Dan 1234. Big Dan 1234, known all over the PUBG circuit as one of the strongest players with a 1.3 KD. Most kills of 5, 13 overall in 10 matches. Very, very strong there. He has got, out of 10 matches, top 10 rate. He's got a 20 rate, guys. Very, very strong with this guy. Then we've got the Danger Mouse UK. Danger Mouse UK, known all around the PUBG circuit, known everywhere. This guy is known to hide in bushes. Let's see his stats. He's got a 0.86 KD, guys. Very bushwookie strong in this guy. Out of 105 matches, he's got 2 wins. Most kills, 6. 4 of them being AFKs. A long kill, decent enough, of 281 meters. Very strong. Yes, yes, Scratchy, he did. He was on 0.72 KD with a squad wide of Thumbless, hiding in a bush, no doubt. It brought him up to 0.86. He's got an average damage of 110. Very, very strong. So guys, let's move on to another player. As you can, what? Who the fuck is this? BLK McEvie? Now this member here is unknown to BLK, but he's got a total of 30 matches. 30 matches, guys. 0 wins, 13 kills, most being 3, and the longest of 48.53 meters. My god, this guy is an animal. As you can see with these stats and with these kills, he will be a BLK captain one day. We have 84 in, guys. We're going to start this up. We're going to go ahead and hit start. In fact, we're going to go do it now. 85 in. We have started. There we go, guys. We've got a message. But it's start. Start, man. Calm your knickers. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Let's give him a wee bit of pressure here, guys. Okay. I think I spelled that wrong, but let's go ahead. So, guys, we're jumping into the first match here in Sonic. We've got six-man squads. We've got a full 84 in, which means 14, is it 13 or 14 squads. And I'm going to die off the rip here. I'm going to bring it back real slow. And we're going to get you the action from an aerial view, hopefully, but don't have to follow people. Let's get this action on the road. Sonic, six-man squads. Six-man squads. It's going to be hectic, guys. There's going to be a lot of third-partying. There's going to be a lot of... Look at this. Look at this sexual being here, guys. With the white tracksuit. White tracksuit. Got a balaclava on. Got the military cap on. Looking real, real spicy. So let's walk about the field here. Yes, and here we have Danger Mouse. Guys, this is Danger Mouse. We were talking about this guy earlier. He is a danger to the field. He is an up and up. Look at this. He is an upcoming superstar in the PUBG circuit. Absolutely low-key dress sense. Doesn't want to put his balaclava on. Doesn't want to put his white tracksuit on. Just wants to keep it real low-key. Throwing a few apples at people. Just getting his aim on the go. Loving that there from Danger Mouse UK. Let's not forget, guys. This guy has a 0.8 KD. Very, very strong. Things like this. Bushes. Grass. Walls for 3 pain. This is where you'll find Danger Mouse. This is his home, guys. This is where he will be. Guys, if you run up here. And you're running up here and you can't see anyone. Because Danger Mouse is here. He's 3 peeking you with an M16. So, guys, we've got a flight plan right across the middle of the map. Right over boot camp. Let's see who has the bollocks to go to boot camp. He was born in Bantai. He was actually born in Bantai. On his birth certificate under the 0.8 KD, it does say he is a resident still of Bantai. Let's see if he still resorts to the Bantai way. It is well known in Bantai that you do hide in bushes if you can't find a safe house to hide in. Let's go ahead and drop straight into the water here, guys. As you can see, we have people dropping with us. Look at this. It's the Kampong gang. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six, full squad. Full squad right there, guys, at Kampong. We have got it early at Kampong here now, guys. Let's see if we can get killed. Look at this. This is a waste of a balaclava and a white trackie, but we're going to do it anyway. We're going to rummage around the bottom here. We're going to do a wee think. Let's see if we can get straight out onto aerial view straight away here, guys. Let's get this match on the go. Let's get the kills on the go. Don't see any kill. There we go. Killed. There we go. I've drowned. Spectate. Straight out into aerial view, guys. Truth. Edgy doesn't know how to do this. Prototype does. Don't worry about it. So, straight into the action here, guys. Where are we? Wow. One... Few people went to boot camp, but all the action is happening over here. I don't even know where this is, guys. I'm not gonna lie, I don't drop here. This is Camp Bravo, guys. All the action is in Camp Bravo. We have three teams in Camp Bravo. Danger Mouse! Danger Mouse is here at Camp Bravo. This is going to be good. Shots off here. 22 health took off straight away here now. Someone's got a Vacky. Vacky and chill. This look, yep, it's this man Extreme. Extreme's got the Vacky here. Team number 4 with Zombie Nation. Dead Zombie Nation and on Team 5. Team 5 with Godmother Team, are they? And T-Solo is getting chased here now, guys. Getting chased here now. We're missing action over there. But we're going to stay here with these three teams at Camp Bravo. Let's get a wee bit higher in this aerial view here, guys. So we have three teams. Team 13, Team 5, and Team 4. All looking for loot in Camp Bravo. Danger Mouse right in the middle there, holding the middle building. Doesn't know that Bishop is right on his right-hand side. Looking to his right-hand side here now. Danger Mouse is close to Bishop. Let's go around. These two teams are circling away. Oh, we have shots over here now. Team 13 off Mr. Carp. Mr. Money has backed out of Camp Bravo, but we have Danger Mouse and Bishop. Bishop takes shots. Danger Mouse goes down. Danger Mouse goes down. I think it's thirsting. Oh my god, the travesty. The absolute travesty. But here we have the goat going in. The Bishop throws it right through the building. Comes out and faces him. Bishop goes down. Bishop goes down. He's circling now. He's going back up for the thirst. Getting thirsted here now by another player. Mr. Pyle across the fucking way. Oh, his team wasn't even there to help. His team, two of them, right beside the action here, guys. Never help. Can't believe the man Danger Mouse is out. What a play from Bishop. Honestly, this is why these guys are all in this PGI Invitational, BLK Invitational for $12,000 first prize. Yes, this is why this is happening, guys. So here we have ads. O2. Oh, Carp. Carp's fighting with Extreme. Carp, he's running. He's giving them the runaround. He's over the wall, but he's going to run straight into him again. No, he's hiding behind the wall. Extreme doesn't know where he is. He's going to come out and face him. Here he comes, and he downs him. Downs him, going straight for the thirst. No. Pyle's friends come round. He does get thirsted out, though. And Pyle gets tucked down. Team 4 doing work here, guys. Ads from Team 4 does get down, and Team 13 is gone. Team 4 doing work here at Camp Bravo. Isn't it Camp Bravo? Yeah. Camp Bravo. Team 5 still holding back, though. Team 4's other two teammates are gone. They are out the back, and they are saying, fuck this, I am out. We have got action at Quarry. Let's go to Quarry, guys. Let's get straight to Quarry. See that there, Campong gang, still a full team. Why are we stopping? Come on, let's get their camera. Here we go. And pop. And pop. There we go. So we've got the aerial view here of Assassin's favorite place to land, Quarry. Quarry here. Team 7 go out, and 11 go out. Diablo had high hopes for you, guy. So sorry, you didn't make the cut, unfortunately. This is the BLK. Welcome, Sophie. This is the BLK Invitational for $12,000 first prize. We have Team 2 here with Ergy and Will. Will114, a very well-known player in the PUBG circuit, has held number 1 in the leaderboards for the last 3 seasons. Very, very, very good player. Who do we have down here? We have Willie Dabloon. And he is on his knees. No, he's up. His mate has got him up. Team 2 are back to full strength with Thread and Dabloon. They're running back down. I hear a vehicle starting up. Yes, they are in the three-wheeler of the tuk-tuk. Going towards their friends now, Will and Blaston. Loving that there, player in the tuk-tuk from Team 2. Guys, let's... Oh, Team 14 are bugging out. There's only 3 of them. So they are going to rotate around the right-hand side towards between Quarry and Boot Camp here. We've got a very central circle. Don't hear any shots at the minute. We're all pretty much spread out. Team 6 up at Paradise there. Team 14... split in 2, half outside Boot Camp, half coming towards them. They're gonna link up. Team 2 has one player in boot camp, very ballsy. Team 3 has two players beside boot camp in the warehouses. Let's have a look around there. No one at this side of the map at all. Very strong here. 51 alive, 11 teams, 6 minutes gone. Back over to you, Jeff. Well, Jeff, here we have team 9 coming right out of the boot camp here. No, team boot. Yep, there we go. Now, Jeff, I'm going to take back over from you. You're not excited. Just going to let it go. Team 9 here. What do you call that? Ban or something? Oh, team 3 is taking shots from somewhere. I think they're team killing each other. Let's go see. And they are. It's a team kill from team 3. GG's, guys. That's an S12K to the face. Let's see. Can we get there? Here's suppressed M24 in the background, though. And it is a team 3 thirst. Team 3 thirst. So we have Mr. AKA Nike85. Has thirsted out his boy. Mike, what have you got to say for yourself? This is for $12,000. And I don't understand why you would put yourself down. But as you see, Mike is well stacked up with a pan. He's got a QBU. He has also got a level 3 bag, a level 2 helmet, and a Vacky. Just dropped his S12 there for a nice Vacky and chill. Very well done there from young Nike. Team 2 all on his own there. Young Desi in boot camp all on his own. But Team 14 with a full 6-man squad here are circling. Let's see where the action is, guys. Team 9 and Team 12 are going to run into each other. Let's get there. EGX is going to be lit. All I can say. It's going to be lit. So here we've got Team 12 here. On the back of Team 9. We've got Big Yo. Block Beast. B-Max. And Just Win, baby. Just Win, baby, out in front here. I think Mr. Work would see them. Let's get down to his view and see what he can do. Yeah, so Mr. Work is running on the back of Big Yo. Big Yo doesn't know he's coming, though. Yep. Pulled out a nade. I think he's too far for a nade, my guy. You need to push up a wee bit more. So here we go. Let's follow. We've got Just Work pushing on the back of Team 9 here with Big Yo, Block Beast, and B-Max. Sees them in the compound. Hayden. He's looking for that opportunity to take one of them down with a clear headshot. What gun's he got? He's got a Vacky. What else? Let's see what you've got now. And an M4. Very capable gun. Let's see if he can use it. He's got a scope on it. I think he does. He takes out the Vacky for close range. Moves in. Sees him in the house. Cocks a grenade. Jumps out of the house. Big Yo jumps out. Throws a grenade at him. Doesn't connect. Big Yo takes cover with two of them in the shack. Closes the door. And he's straight in behind him here. Oh. Straight in with it. Oh. Takes one down. Thirsts him straight out there. Takes two. No. Big Yo. Jay got work. Took two of them out in the shack. Done absolute work with the M4 and the Vacky. Their teammate B-Max. There is another one. But he's gone. He is. He's out of here. B-Max is returning now. So there is four here. He doesn't know there's four here. But he is returning. He's like, fuck, I am going to get that. On the open him up. 80 for the headshot. And he goes down. Straight out with a third. B-Max 97. Thanks for playing back to the lobby. Oh my word. Living that extreme was on the back of the bike there with Stinger. And jumps off mid crossing. He is down. Let's go have a word. What happened, my guy? Just jumped off for the crack. Okay. Are they coming back for you? Or? Yeah, he's come back. Is he gonna run over you? Is he gonna get you up? Or? Yep. Team 12 hear this, though. And they're not pushing. Oh my goodness. Smokes are out as well. Great team play here from Team 4. Team 4 seem to know what they're doing. Maybe. Throwing a smoke out there. Getting tags on it, though. Oh, Team 6 up in the hills, shooting down at Team 4 as well. It's a three-way battle. Fleur goes up in the background. Shots ring out from everywhere. Team 9 also in the mix here. Beautiful headshot there from Summon number 6. Team 6 getting the headshot there on Stinger. Stinger is down behind the rock. Just Work is pushing for the kills. Let's back out of here and get a wee bit higher. Pushing really hard as Work here. Don't know if Zombie Nation knows he's there. Gets tagged up. Works goes down. Oh, and Stinger gets thirsted out. Team 6 are pushing on the back of them here. This is still a three-way battle. Team 12, Team 4 in a really, really bad position here. Team 12 also not great here. Oh, but this is a wide flank. This is a wide flank from the Condor. The Condor is a very sneaky player. Known in the PUBG world for his sniper and his AR skills. Let's see what the Condor has to do here. Takes a sniper shot out of extreme. Misses. Let's get down to his view. Condor sneaking on the right hand side here, right on the blue edge. Absolutely doing work here is Young Sang has took out two of Team 4 and one of Team 12. And doing more work, but he's down to one shot himself. His teammates up the hill need to push down, need to give him some help here, but they're not doing it. The crazy Condor is putting shots on though. And Sang! Wow, Extreme takes him down and Thirst. So we have Team 4 in rags with one player up. Team 6 are dipping. Team 6 are dipping. No? Are they? Is he peeking? Let's go see. Wow, it's a good nade there from Extreme. He knows they're there. Takes him down. Great player, this Extreme lad. Very, very talented on the PUBG fucking circuit. Takes him down. Thirst him straight out. Now it's Mr. Shade. Mr. Shade Reaver, Mr. Extreme. He's got a grenade cocked. Wow. Beautiful grenade. Takes him out. Bye bye, Extreme. Team 12 still holding their position there. Condor, I think he's going for the loot. He is. He's going to stack himself up. And he's going to make this work for himself. Guys, the circle is pushing across past boot camp onto the left side of the top left island. I don't know if these guys are in a great position. Let's get down to Nan's Pie. Seems to be action happening in Nan's Pie. There is. Let's get there. Action at Nan's Pie. Team 10 on Team 1 here. Team 10 are the favourites. Team 10 have been running away with the previous game. Jeffrey goes down. Oh, it's a team kill. Team headshot. I don't think he meant it. I think he's going to get him up. So Team 10 here still going to have their full four. Jefferson are down. Hypochondriac, he is going to dip. He's saying, fuck this, I'm out. Yep, Jefferson gets thirsted out here. Team 10 maybe down to one player. Not a good start there from Team 10. They do need the placement points. Placement points do not come into play until the top 5. So Hypochondriac, he is doing the right move. He is moving on out of there. There is 1, 2, 3, 4 Team 10 players left. They are in a strong position. Going to loot up and move along. Hypochondriac, let's see what he's doing. Let's see what he's rocking. Here he is, guys. He's hiding. He's got his noob jacket on. He's got a 6X on an AK. And that's it. Oh, no, he's got an ump also. Very, very strong combination. Let's see what the recoil control is like for Mr. Kondrak on that AK. Team 10. Wow. A member of Team 10 has killed himself. Let's see where he is. I don't see him. Very, very strong player, though. I respect it. Let's get to the bridge, though. Looks like Team 14 and Team... Oh. Team 2 are going to run into each other. Let's get on top of them. A flare does go off. Team 8 are pushing in behind Team 2. Team 2 are about to get pinched here. Team 4... there he is. BLK McGee. Absolute beast. Team 14 are rotating to circle. Very smart play. Team 7 are at the other side towards ruins and the bridge. Holding that position. Team 3... see one player way in the background all on his own. That is a beautiful headshot by Mr. Shade on Willie Luton. Doubleton, whatever his name is. Beautiful headshot. Very close together here. Young Desi is the only player left in Team 2, I think. No, could be wrong. Could be wrong. Here we go. Team 10 pushing down. Team 2 deciding to go into the water here. Team 10 and Team 2 are going to run into each other here, guys. Young Desi does take out Mr. Shade. That is Mr. Shade gone. He's going to thirst him out. Young Desi is going to loot up. Oh, yeah. Hypercondriac. He is watching him. He knows Team 10 are there. And he knows they just killed his last teammate. So he's being very smart here. He's playing the coast. If it was me, I'd have played that coast and worked my way up there. But Mr. Condriac has no fear. He will run on the side of the team. Team 10 about to run into Team 8 here. This is going to be a battle. 5 on Team 8. 4 on Team 10. Let's see what happens. Danny Drake. Danny Drake is coming up. Italian Curry. Saint Souls. Pooh Bear. Big Dan. They're waiting on a care package. This is going to be tense. Let's get down to the action. Shots going out. Soul going down straight away. Oh my goodness. Return of the Midge is straight in. Them guys aren't even helping. They're waiting on their package. They're like, fuck you. Yeah. Saint Soul gets thirsted out straight away. Nades come out. Italian Curry straight under the package. Takes shots though. And down straight away from Hoover. Henry the Hoover does take down with the QB. Shots are ringing out from Vackies. Vackies are dangerous up close. Yep. Take both of them down to 50% health. But Danny does get thirsted out. Unfortunately for Danny, he is thirsted. Team 14 taking a high position there in the background. Very tense here. Team 10, 3 left. Team 8, 4 left. 1 down to 1 shot. Hypercondriac has decided to move off. Here we go. Yep. Return of the Mids takes down Leopards as well. Money Zoe goes down. Money Eye Zoe, one of the best female players of PUBG, goes down. And she is down. Wow. So we have 2. And thirsted out. And 1 left. 1 left. Nope, 2 left. Yeah, Mannix is thirsted out. There's only 1 left of Team 8. Henry the Hoover and the Midge. First teammate of Italian Curry. 2 of his teammates are down. I don't think he's going to get them up though. BLK McGive goes down. Let's stay with this fight at the minute. Both of them down to 50% health. Henry Hoover goes down. It's all to do with the Mids and the Curry. Here we go. Last 2. You need to push hard before he gets a heal off. Gets him down. Both down. Oh, wow. Return of the Midge. Going to see if Henry the Hoover, they're going to get level 3'd up. 15 seconds to move on circle. Let's see if they make it, guys. Team 12. Where are they? Team 12 in circle at the edge, not very good position. Team 14 up high, still not a very good position. Best position here is Team 2, with Team 7 a C on top of them. Let's get there. Team 2, Team 7 here in a battle. Team 7 taking up houses. Team 2, Young Desi goes down, gets thirsted out straight away. Taking no prisoners. Team 2 have a strong, if they can rotate out and take each flank, they would have a very strong position, but I don't think they know what they're doing. Hits K, card bug. Takes down. Yep, there's number 14 starting to fall. Stupid. Another one down from Team 2. Wow, Condor. Team 12. Wow, beautiful shot there from Condor. Absolutely rampaging. Team 2 were steamrolled, basically. Didn't have the attackers, didn't know what they were doing. Team 7, very strong position here. Happy Kiwi or Kawagi, whatever the fuck his name is getting shot in the back by Young Hypercondriac. He is afraid of everything. God love him. But shots are ringing out from Team 12. They are shooting over to Team 7. Team 14, very strong position, but they should have moved down a bit earlier, I feel. Team 14 are starting to rotate. Circle is coming. You're going to try to get Pooh Bear up. He is the god. I don't know if it's going to happen for them, though. You can't actually make it down these rocks without Dan. I just don't think experienced players. Team 12, though, if it was myself, I would have been moved over to this coast. But they are at that side. Henry the Hoover and the Midge are moving up on them. This side is a very, very small slither, as you can see here. It is going to move across, but they continue to shoot from the left-hand side. I don't know if they see Henry the Hoover. Mr. Condor is moving towards the water. They are facing each other. They're bound to see each other. Yes, he does see him. Condor moves towards cover. Yep, Henry sees him too. Both of them take a tree. Both of them are aiming. I think this is an SLR. Nope, M24. Looking at him with an M24. He's hard peeking. Oh my goodness. Henry the Hoover was hard peeking. Rings out shots. Hits him down to 25% health. Condor is going to heal. He's pushing. Henry Hoover is pushing hard. Does he get the heal off? He doesn't get the heal off here. He takes out his AK. Wow! Oh. Henry Hoover is down in one shot though. Midge does need to push up and give his man a hand. He is getting absolutely fucking... Oh wow, return to the Midge. Absolutely reels him from behind the tree. And there goes Team 12. GG's Team 10. I did say they were a strong team. I did say they were contenders. 5 kills for Henry the Hoover. Absolutely on a rampage, guys. This guy is... amazing. Circle is moving in 25 seconds, guys. Let's see what happens. Trap God, stand on top of the hill like a fucking idiot. Don't know what he's doing. But Team 14 are in zone here. Team 14 have the best position. Team 7 are starting to rotate, though. 3 teams left, guys. 14 alive. Let's get down to it. Let's get a proper aerial view. Let's get nice and high. Here we go. Beautiful. Here we go. Team 14. Swag. What's this new shit at the top of the map? Anyway. 2 from Team 10. Got a full 6 from Team 7. And a full 6 from Team 14. One is very high though, and he will be pushed by zone. As you can see, great movement here from Team 7. They're like sheep. Got obviously Daddy Sheep here at the front. And the rest of the little sheep are coming in a line. Do they know there's guys across the water? Let's find out. Shots ringing out here. Obviously, Trap God is getting shot at by Team 7. I think they're quite oblivious to what danger is coming behind them with Henry the Hoover and Return to the Midge. Henry Hoover gets into the zone. Hurt. Wow, Midge is going to be really, really hurting here, guys. He's going to be really hurting. The same, let's find out. Henry the Hoover sees all those guys. 14 and Team 7 are fighting here. They do not know Henry's behind them. He does take aim. Is he going to take a shot? Very smart move there. He didn't take a shot. There's 3 to his left, and he's looking here at Thomas. But there's 2 to his right and 3 to his left. Don't think this is a good move from young Henry. Young Henry is getting joined by his partner though in a ghillie suit. He can be the grass if he wishes to be. What's he got? A QBU. A special off. Henry does take shots. He does. Now they're aware. They know there's people behind them. They're all starting to move. Yep. Straight down goes Henry to Hoover. The Midge is panicking. The Midge is panicking and gets absolutely reeled. Good night, Henry to Hoover. And Return to the Midge. Thanks for playing. Back to the lobby. So here we have it. 6-on-6. Team 14 on Team 7. Team 7, I did say it come in here as the favourites. Team 10 were close second place. But they did lose players early on. Which did put them at a disadvantage. So here we have Team 14 nicely spread out. Team 7 tightly compact. But they do have zone. But Team 14 are moving into it in a minute. Team 7 are letting them in the zone quite cheaply here. If it was my team, I wouldn't be letting them in just as cheap. I'm going to be honest with you. Let's see what happens here. So Team 7 are looted up. They're starting to spread. That's a nice fan maneuver there, taking the ridges. Looking down. Spotting them out. Calling out to their friends. Where they are. Trap God has come down from his high perch, which is a good move. Here comes the suppressed SKS shots. Shots starting to ring out here. Very cagey from both players, both teams, because they know this is the money round. This is for $12,000. HK, Carbug, Xbox, takes out BLK, McGeeve, whoever the fuck that is. But he takes them out anyway. No one sees Poe the God. He's doing a beautiful flank on the right here. They're all concentrating on the houses here. Beautiful flank. Oh my goodness, if this pulls off, this will be absolutely play of the fucking tournament. One's holding back Happy Kiwi. Run the bottom now. Needs to shoot him. Down some. Beautiful. One knows. Carbug knows. Team 14 are in rags here. Here they go, one-on-one. Wow! Gun skill. First strike straight away. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Two left here. Three left. Three on one here, over here. Oh, takes one down. Two on one in this building right here. Gets him at the end of it. Wow. Mr. God here is doing work. YKC55 thirsting out here. He's going to try to get his friends up. He needs to get shots on these two. He needs to at least thirst one of them. He's not. It's going to be, it could be a three on one here. Going for the res. Nade comes over, it's not going to be good enough. Short. One's up. He's healing. Beautiful flank though. If he can get round this corner, he can take out two of them. Third one is there. Go for him. Headshot down. One on one. One on one here, guys. He's down to one shot though. Can he get a heal off? Yes, he's going to be able to get a heal off. He's not getting a heal off. Get a heal off. Here we have it, one on one, two down. He's in the building now. He really does need to get a heal off. He's going for the revive. Not the smartest thing I would do. My leg, appreciate the follow. Welcome to Team BLK. Two on one here now, guys. Two on one. He gets the heal off eventually. I think it was too late. He should have got the heal off and pushed. But here we have YKC55 holding. They're going to get both. It's going to be 3-on-1. Very, very silly play here by Poo Da God. Very silly play. He had him on a 1-on-1 situation. And he let the three of them get back up. He's there. He's creeping. Puts him down to one shot. Gets one down again. Oh, he's one shot himself. Now they're going to push. Both of them are going to push. It's Ring of Rosie. Gets two down! Absolute god! He is god! One left, one on one, one shot. Unclutches, guys. Here we have it. The winning team. Team 7. Poo to God with 5 kills, clutching up the end there. Absolutely annihilating. Team 7, I think it was. Team 14. So, mentions. Poo to God, obviously, with that clutch, 3-on-1, ended up getting the win and 5 kills. YKC55, top killer with 8. Along with him is HK Carbud, Xbox, 5 kills. GG's to him as well. Henry the Hoover with 6, and Return of the Midge with 5. There you have it, guys. Really, really well done to all players. Yeah, fantastic. Well done. Round of applause, guys, in chat. Crowd goes wild. Let's see what the crowd has to say to everything. No, I can't actually. Let's exit the lobby. Let's see who's talking to me on Snapchat. Decent. Hey guys, let's get another one set up. Get this rock and roll. What are you talking about, phase, man? That's about the fella. Let's try a wrangle this time. You're very quiet. Shut your face. Shut your whore mouth. It's whore. TPP. We're gonna go for... fours. Fire up, lads. Oh, shit. Yep, there we go. It's Star Trek or shit, man. Don't like it. Decent. Deleted it. I can't use my radar then, you know what I mean? So yeah. Milky Bomb. Team 13 looking real spicy here now. We've got Mushu, Milky Bomb, Breakfast, and Bentley 20. Very spicy squad. Looking like the favorite so far here. Milky just sent me a message saying Scratchy is terrible. Oh my word, I can't believe he just said that. Let's get some music on here, guys, till this fills up real quick. It took about 5 minutes to fill up the last time. That maybe because it was people want to play more bigger squads, but once you get past 20, 25, it just poof, up it goes. So that's my views on Yoga Maybe. It was a good job, yeah. Thank you. Looking to know. Interested. Drop. Yes, let's get a bit of music on here. I am streaming on Twitch, Mixer, YouTube, Facebook, and Hyperbeam. This video will get banned because of the music, but YouTube can suck my balls. Prototype wants to listen to music. Prototype will get to listen to music. Actually, should do it on my browser because see the fucking app? It is fucking terrible. Close. Get away from me. If I just open it on the browser, it's fucking, there's no problems with it at all. I don't don't know how Truth doesn't be able to do that straight away. It's fucking easy. You don't have to follow anyone or fucking fuck about. Straight out into the action. Any chance? It's fucking... See, Spotify, broke as fuck. You know what? Get off my page. YouTube. So guys, the lineup so far, starting at the top, we've got Milky Bomb. Milky Bomb with a 2.16 KD, over 289 matches, 8 wins, 606 kills, most of 13. Obviously his radar was turned on that game. Then we've got Mushu, 1-2-1, with a KD of a 4.55, very decent. 3 wins off 41 matches, 173 kills, most 16. Obviously he took a land of Milky Bomb's radar. Then we've got Breakfast. The KD of 1.03, obviously not a radar user, which we are happy with. 1 win out of 64 matches, most of 5, a 307 longest kill, obviously a scab. But we'll move on to Bentley 20. Bentley 20 here with a 1.88 KD for 17 matches, 1 win, 30 kills. Most kills of 11. Obviously Bentley has his radar switched on. There we go guys, that's the lineup so far. As they come in, we will check the stats and we will talk about them as a group. Come on, get in. Hurry up. Usually I check what customs are on. There's not that many, to be fair. We'll check. We'll keep an eye on the stream as well for all any sneaky stream snipers. We'll call them out straight away. That's just the way we work it here at BLK. Sorry I don't have the face in the stream today. I am absolutely beautiful. I just haven't had a fresh cut in a few weeks. I'm looking a wee bit rough, as if it was a little piss. I was. Should have just done Sonic. Right, all the wee plebs don't like playing there, there's not much, there's nowhere to hide really. Very special players have left. That's unfortunate, guys.
have made me older since the last time that I saw your pretty face. A thousand lies have made me colder, and I don't think I can look at this the same. But all the miles that separate, they disappear now when I'm dreaming of your face. I'm here without you, baby, but you're still on my lonely mind. I think about you, baby, and I dream about you all the time. I'm here without you,
baby.
And
he is broadcasting at the moment. Look, do you sound like it is not bad? You should all go over, have a wee look at BLK and B on his stream. Grab the follow. Me personally couldn't give a fuck about your follows. I really couldn't. Like the wee worms want to play Sonic. Sonic it is.